blocking techniques power is not preferable. You're going to put yourself in a position to get not on the right. Okay? Close the last round of feet coming at you. You have a ride. You have broken arm. Right? So you try to use evasive movement, so what we call escape form, escaping motion, in conjunction with our blocking technique. So what happens is that we're not blocking the power of the technique, we're just redirecting it at the end of the technique. And of course, getting ourselves off that line of attack in a position where we've now weakened that technique.
Is it the point you just said?
Yes. Okay, so we're going to start nice and simple. We're going to do chokespin attacking your right. Okay? So here's the table attack. So when we say escape, we have three levels. Ashiwaza, Ashi Sabaki, Kai Sabaki, Kei Sabaki, or Ashi Sabaki. Which means footwork, bodywork, in that order. Okay? Whether it's a closed Suke or Shuto Ke, doesn't matter. First, foot, body, hand. Okay? Now we're going to come. So, okay. What do you do? Like what you said, this one. Yes, excellent. Why choose a kick?
Because
you're 100% correct. Tsuki, you have a big chance. Right? So we want to change the game. Attack by hand, defend by leg. Attack by leg, defend by hand. Attack straight, counter round. Attack round, straight. So this is the basic idea how to build your counter game, how to build your, what do I use? What choices do I make? Because when you fight it, it all comes down to choices. You pick a good choice, it's good. You pick the wrong choice, it can be not so good. Okay? So, and then of course, I don't want to counter with one technique. I want to try to counter with multiple techniques, a combination of techniques. Okay, so what has happened over time with not being able to fight with full contact and so on, having the control, it limits the amount of techniques that you're going to end up throwing. Okay, so what we want to do is increase the amount of techniques that you're throwing. We've got a fluid combination of techniques, so it makes it very difficult for our opponent to deal with it, okay? So again, using that same idea, hands, feet, straight, round, right? One, then first, kick counter, kick. Two, punch. So in this case, it's kick. Two, punch, punch. What does that do? Increases the distance, right? Especially if I punch to her face, get to actually hit, right? She's not going to be standing there. There's going to be a bit of space created. So it's not found. Then opens up the my for head. So again, by So I'm keeping track of everything that she does. I'm not tuning on. Right? And eventually now desensitize my brain from having somebody throw three, four techniques at me. I'm going to have that freeze up for me. Okay? One more time. Your deck. Remember footwork. And notice my direction. Okay? I'm not going to escape here. Why? That's guaranteed there's going to be another one. Straight line, right? Pressing down momentum. You stay on this line? Oh, good. So, which way?
Angle.
45 degrees relatively. Okay? That is going to change depending on the size of your opponent. Okay? But we're roughly similar size, so I'm going to use about 45 degrees. Right, that now gives me a great angle for my machine.